السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his household, his companions. May Allah bless them and bless every one of us and grant us goodness. My brothers and sisters, I want to commence by thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us the opportunity to gather in his house for this beautiful Friday in a way that we seek his forgiveness and earn closeness to him by his mercy. For myself, it is a very difficult moment, filled with emotions for many reasons. One of them is several people that I have known from this community are no longer with us. And it's the first time that I am back in this particular masjid, Masjid al-Quds, noticing and feeling the absence of a brother very close to me, Brother Abu Bakr Slosh, who passed away in Medina Munawwara. From that time, I have not been here. Every time I came to Cape Town, he was with me. And now, he is in the mercy of Allah. May Allah grant him Jannatul Firdaus and his loved ones. Subsequently, his wife also passed on. And several others passed away too. May Allah grant them all Jannatul Firdaus. We take the opportunity to remember the late Sheikh Fuad, who passed away as well. He was also one very close to my heart. That having been said, my beloved brothers and sisters, we know that Allah blessed us. And the greatest blessing we have is Iman. The fact that we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we are followers of the greatest of creation, the most noble of all prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Muhammadun sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Indeed, we owe it to our forefathers, the dua we give them and the reward they will be receiving for everything they passed down the ladder in a way that it got to us today. We are seated here. We are enjoying the fruits of the sacrifice of the pioneers, those who came a long time back. Their concern was primarily to preserve and protect the deen that they have, and at the same time to convey it to others and to be able to expand in their relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the expansion of the following of this beautiful deen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them all Jannatul Firdaus. If we were to look at our pioneers, a question that would arise in my heart and should arise in yours too: they served, they did, they left a legacy. What am I doing? Subhanallah. What am I doing? That question should be asked by every one of us. The minimum is improve yourself, improve your relationship with Allah, be the best possible member of your family you can be, and try and spread within your community the goodness that you have. Don't be selfish and keep it to yourself. And if you want to spread the goodness, you need to make sure you understand it will only be spread in the best and most beautiful way. Udu'u ila sabili rabbika bil hikmati wal maw'idhati al hasana. Call towards the path of your Lord with wisdom and in the best possible way. The reminders you give should be beautiful reminders. Don't chase people away from the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of your bad behavior, because of bad character and bad habits. So the pioneers brought with them the deen, but where did they get it from? Subhanallah. From their fathers, their forefathers, their teachers, and those who came before them until it met with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Like I said, afdalul khalqi wa akramur rusuli, the best of creation, the most noble of all prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No matter what we say or what we do, we will never ever cause any drop in the status of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. In fact, Allah has elevated him so high that Allah tells us something amazing, something so powerful and so unique in Surah Al-Ahzab. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. Before Allah gives us an instruction to send our salawat and salam upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he tells us that I have done it and the angels have done it, and now we're telling you to do it. So if you don't do it, the loss is only yours, because Allah has already elevated the status of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam prior to him instructing us to send the salawat upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So Allah says, Inna Allaha wa malaikatahu. Indeed, Allah and His angels send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. O you who believe, send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ashabihi wa sallim. My brothers and sisters, there is no one whom Allah says, I have sent blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is no one besides Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam whom that has happened to. And he was indeed the role model. This morning I was going through some of the characteristics of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, only to refresh my mind and only to make me smile, knowing that no matter what people say against the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they will never ever damage that reputation that is intact. Subhanallah, they will only do harm to themselves. And as I was going through, I read, or I came across, I spoke about to some of my friends, the hadith of Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu. And this is speaking about our role model, the role model of all our pioneers, all those who brought the deen to us. Do you know what he says? He says, Wallahi, I served the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam as a servant for 10 years. As a servant for 10 years, I served him. Wallahi ma qala liya uffin qattu, wala qala li shay'in sana'tuhu lima sana'ta. He never ever passed a negative remark or sound against me. Never. I never heard anything negative come from him. He didn't ever say uff to me, nor to anyone else, subhanallah. 10 whole years. Imagine how we treat those who help us. We call them helpers, the helping hands. How we treat our family members. Where is the role model, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in our lives? Then he continues and he says, Wallahi, he never ever told me, why did you do this or why didn't you do this? There were no whys. Imagine someone who is serving you. You never ever told them, why did you do this or why didn't you do this? He never made me feel uncomfortable even once in 10 whole years. And then he says, Wallahi ma masastu khazzan wala dibajan wala hariran alyana min kaffi rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wallahi, I have never touched something softer and more pleasant to the touch than the hands of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. No silk and no beautiful soft material, no matter what it is, nothing have I touched more pleasant and softer to the touch than the blessed hand of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And then he says, wallahi, I have never smelt any fragrance more beautiful, neither musk nor amber. No fragrance more beautiful than the perspiration of the blessed Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Imagine what miracle Allah granted him. You and I, perspiration is considered what? You would need an underarm in order to protect yourself from your body odor. But he sallallahu alayhi wasallam had a body scent. It was a scent. Fragrance. أَفْضَلُ الْخَلْقِ وَأَكْرَمُ الرُّسُلِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَعَلَىٰ آلِهِ وَسَلِّمُ. My brothers and sisters, the way he spoke and the way he addressed people, he was granted an eloquence at a time when people were upon a height of eloquence in Makkah al-Mukarramah. Not once did anyone need to ask him to repeat what he was saying. Never. He used to say it so clearly, you could actually count his words. He used language that was understood by the people. And he spoke very clearly. لَوْ عَدَّهُ الْعَادُّ لَأَحْصَاهُ. If someone wanted to count the words as he spoke, they were able to do that. They understood it. No one ever did not hear him. He knew the volume. He knew who he was speaking to, the language. And it was so clear. May Allah grant us even a droplet of that eloquence. And what was the reason that he was so eloquent? Ya ayyuha ar-rasul balligh ma unzila ilayka min rabbik. O messenger, convey in the highest form the message that Allah has sent down to you, to them. If he was instructed to convey in the clearest and the highest and the best possible way, then Allah would give him all the tools to do that and to achieve it. Imagine you're speaking to a messenger of Allah. Do you really think he's going to address you in a way that you don't know what he is saying? Never. Cannot happen. He was the best, the most eloquent. He spoke so beautifully. Sallallahu alayhi wasallam. May Allah grant us the ability to speak clearly. And may Allah accept it from us. He never swore in his life. Not a single vulgar word. How many of us have let him down by claiming to be his followers, but we swear left, right, and center. We abuse people, our own family members. The F word has become so common in the non-Muslim circles that it has now seeped into our circles. But it is a sin, my brothers and sisters. Abstain from it, even if it is jokingly. Here is our role model. The role model of all the pioneers. They strove so that we could enjoy the fruits. Why are you seated in the masjid today? It's yes, the mercy of Allah. Allah invited you to come here. That's why you are here. Allah placed it in your heart to be here. That's why you are here. It's an invitation. It's the house of Allah. Without that invitation, you would not be here. Hayya 'alal falah. Come to success. That's what Allah said. You want success. And we responded. That's why we're here. But together with the mercy of Allah, it was the effort of some people from the time we were young. And as we grew older, someone made an effort on us, or a little bit later on, there was an effort that was made. May Allah bless those people who made that effort. May Allah bless all of them. Because if you look up the ladder, there is a chain that meets with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. That's why you and I will receive a reward when we teach others goodness. It's not easy. It requires a lot of patience. When you see someone deviating, you need to know how to tackle the person in a way that they come onto the path. You don't tackle them in a way that they go further away from the path. They might say things that are hurtful. They might do things that are hurtful. Try and bring them through. If you have been used by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring people through, you have succeeded. So take it as a challenge upon yourself. Whenever you see evil, or whenever you see that which is unacceptable, try to help the people. Are they not your brothers and sisters somehow? If you were able to help them, would you not bring them in? Look at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He tried hard. As a result, Allah guided Abu Sufyan radiyallahu anhu, who was an enemy at one stage. Allah guided Khalid ibn al-Walid radiyallahu anhuma. Allah guided Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu. Yet at one stage, they were enemies of Islam. They had evil intention. That was our role model, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. My brothers and sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam treated children with utmost respect. When he saw a child, he spent a moment to give the child importance. Do you do that? This is why we're failing with our children. We abuse the children instead of respecting them and offering them the honor and the time and the importance and the attention. Today there is an attention deficit that our children are struggling with, and it shows up later on in their lives. When the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, my role model and yours, when he took time to give attention to children of the community. One moment. Salaamu alaykum. What is your name? Mashallah. And so on. Even just that much, the child feels part of a broader community, safe and secure, developing, and the child will then blossom at some stage and give back to the same society. We have sometimes, I think, we have failed when it comes to nurturing young children to be the leaders when we leave. May Allah grant us leadership in the first place. So my brothers and sisters, it's important for us to know why we say the best of creation, the most noble of all prophets of Allah. When Allah has chosen to bless and salute Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he tells us the angels have done the same, then Allah says, oh, you who believe, you do it too. Subhanallah. And Allah says, you know what, when you do it, oh, you who believe, your reward will be tenfold. When you send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, you will be blessed 10 times as a result. Man salla alayya wahidatan sallallahu alayhi biha ashra. Whoever sends blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam once, Allah will bless him or her 10 times as a result of what they have just said, what they did. So the blessing is for who? Let's continue to send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam on a daily basis. And with that, let's make sure we lead our lives in a way that we're not an embarrassment on the day of judgment against ourselves. I challenge you, my brothers and sisters, to improve on all fronts. Imagine we have a disease that we cannot see, that is floating across the globe and has taken every country on earth by storm. We are so fortunate to be in this masjid after a pause of how long? We are seated in a specific way. We are dressed in a specific way by the command of a disease. Why can't we dress in a specific way by the command of Allah? When Allah told us to dress in a certain way, to carry ourselves in a certain way, we weren't so interested. But when a disease you cannot see told you to do that, we did it. in such a way that if someone did not do it, we became irritated. Subhanallah. May Allah grant us success. May He make us from those who realize and understand. Wallahi, my brothers and sisters, I want to say to you today, any instruction given by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam can only have been given because it is best for us to follow that. And any prohibition that he has declared can only be prohibited because it is not good for us. Whether you and I understand it or not is irrelevant. The love I have for the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam should be more than the love I have for my parents, my children. Sorry, let me not even say parents. Nowadays, you got to start off with my spouse, mashallah, right? My wife. La ilaha illallah. You know, beneath the mask, I can't see, but when the eyes start scrunching this way and scrunching the other way, I know people are smiling and laughing, mashallah. But it's true. More than your spouse, more than your parents, more than your children, more than your brothers and sisters, and guess what? More than yourselves and myself. That's the love I need to follow. My brothers, my sisters, I need to follow this beautiful example so that one day my grandchildren and great-grandchildren, may Allah grant us offspring who will be steadfast on the deen, will consider you and I pioneers. What did this man do? What did this woman do? Oh, they sacrificed. They were role models in society. Someone saying to you, my grandfather, my great-grandfather, mashallah, it's so good. My great-grandfather was the first hafiz in Cape Town. Have you heard someone say that? In the case of Cape Town, it's probably the great-great-grandfather, mashallah, because you're fortunate. I'd like to believe that this part of the country was blessed before other parts of the country when it comes to the service of the Quran. May Allah grant us all the acceptance to be from Ahlul Quran, the people of the Quran. Do you know who the people of the Quran are? Allah says, Hum Ahlullahi wa khasatuhu. They are the people of Allah and they are the VIPs, the special people of Allah. You give importance to the book of Allah, Allah gives importance to you. It is amazing when you give importance to what Allah has given importance to, your status is elevated. You give importance to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, I told you, his status is intact. What happens? Your status and mine is elevated because I have given that importance to the right direction. Similarly, the word of Allah, spend time with it. The remembrance of Allah, the dhikr that people have abandoned today. Remember Allah often. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu dhkurullaha dhikran kathira. The same surah, Surah Al-Ahzab. Allah is telling us, oh you who believe, remember Allah tremendously. A lot of remembrance. You're going to go back to Allah. You're going to meet the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam on the pond known as Al-Hawd. He will recognize you as being a member of his ummah. Oh Allah, let the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam recognize us and forgive our shortcomings. Live your lives in a beautiful way. Learn to be people who have outshone others in their character. And charity begins at home. Now that we have a different type of a norm, we don't know how long it's going to last, but may Allah grant us such cure and such protection from the disease that He eradicate this disease from the atmosphere. Ameen. But for now, we know that we're probably at home more than we've been before. And if that is the case, my brothers and sisters, it will require a little bit more patience from you. Learn to spend a moment to follow such a great sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam being my role model and yours, to go out of your way to say good words, loving, kind words to those whom you live with. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless every one of us and grant us all the best of this world and the next. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the greatest intercession on the day of judgment, which is the intercession of none other than Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And may Allah gather us around that pond known as Hawdul Kawthar. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us swift entry into Jannatul Firdaus without reckoning, only through the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد.